I'm the great Orbax. We're here with Dr. Mike Massa today. We're going to talk about laminar flow. Mike? Was that too fast? I'm trying to bring energy.
Yeah, you did. So we've been looking at fluid flow, and here we've got a great demonstration to illustrate what we've been talking about, the continuity equation.
Continuity. It's the most important thing for any experiment. You've probably seen this a thousand times, right? A simulation on the internet, pictures in your textbook, where they show these stripes and regions of flow where they constrict and they change and do whatever. But this is a real physical version of that built in.
So what you're looking at here is streamlined flow. We've got water coming in at the back and flowing forward and across and leaving at a certain constant rate.
What I got here is we've got these little injection points. I'm going to do a little small injection of dye into the actual flow. And you'll be able to see these streams move as laminar flow would take place. So let's take a look here.
What's cool is that you don't see any mixing, right? The jet that comes out on this side stays always to the left. Those streams aren't crossing. This is exactly what laminar flow is. They pick a path and they follow it. And if you look carefully, you'll be able to see that the speed increases as they approach this constriction. It gets a little faster.
The same rate of fluid is coming in as is going out. So it has to speed up to get out of there quicker to make space for more material. There's two phases to this. As you can probably see, and you probably noticed already, there's a small constriction at the bottom of the chamber. So you can actually reset these syringes to inject at a level that's much lower. So now you're going to have flow taking place, your laminar streams coming down and striking the small constriction. Boom. It goes right into that weird turbulent jet stream.
Laminar flow works really well as long as the speed isn't too high and you have the streams staying on their separate sides and not crossing. But you're going to find that once the speed gets very high, or in this case, once you start mixing with the water on the other side of this tiny constriction, the difference in speed of that jet going through is going to start mixing with the surrounding water. We get what you call turbulence. It's the breakdown of this laminar flow.
So that's laminar flow and the breakdown of laminar flow all within the same system just by changing the geometry. So hey, get back to work.